Success is actually a decision, ultimately. If you decide, I have succeeded, then you've succeeded. If you decide, no, I haven't succeeded, then you haven't succeeded. So ultimately, we have to get to the point, a point where we decide, we make a decision. Am I going to decide that I have succeeded? I've already succeeded. Since it's only a decision, we can say, conceptually, we have to say, well, I've already succeeded. There's no gap. There's no gap at all. So the way to speak of it, using words, is to say, I've already succeeded. That removes any possibility of there being a gap. That's what's most important. You see, we get tricked by words. We shouldn't be tricked by them, but the important aspect is to insist there is no gap. And the best way to do that is to say, I've already succeeded. That removes the gap conceptually, entirely, doesn't it? So I'm sitting here today saying, I haven't succeeded yet. I thought I succeeded. Well, again, ultimately, it's to decide that I have succeeded. And that is the way of saying it, is I've already succeeded. I have already succeeded. And that's it. We think that there's something else, that something has to happen. No, nothing has to happen. Success is realizing that nothing has to happen. I'm already what I am. So we have to say, I've already succeeded. Not like I managed to succeed. Well, then that's bringing time into it. Well, how did you manage to succeed? I mean, what? You know, no, I've already succeeded. It's a decision. Succeeded in what? Succeeded in accepting that I don't need to succeed. See? Accepting to know that I don't need to succeed at anything because I'm already perfect. So I've already succeeded in accepting that I don't need to succeed at anything. This is what is so difficult to get to in this world. I've already succeeded in recognizing I don't need to succeed at anything. Therefore, there is no fear of failure. No fear of inadequacy. No fear of incompetence. No fear of incapacity. No need for a personality. I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. And again, this seems so simple. But in this world, that the entire world is geared towards moving your attention away from this. To not even considering this, to believing that this is the height of insanity, height of failure. This is the worst failure possible to see it this way. So the whole world is geared that way, which is why it's so difficult to get to this here. So difficult to get to this here. And when we come in, we're young, we may have this ideology and may see it this way. People say, oh, no, don't worry. Give it time. You'll learn that this isn't so, and you'll go away from it. And so they don't listen to you because they say, oh, you're young, you're stupid, you don't know the ways of the world, you don't know the opportunity here, opportunity here to fail. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed at anything. I don't need to succeed in any way. And that's it. Maintaining this awareness is the teaching. If there's a teaching, then you can say that there's a teacher. But it's the teaching that's important. This is the teaching. I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. And of course, everybody in the world will say you're absolutely nuts. You're guaranteed to be a failure. I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I'm already perfect. I can't fail. See, I know I can't. I already know I can't fail. So why do I need to succeed? I don't have any need to succeed. So maintaining this awareness is the teaching. And this is what has proved to be so difficult in this world. The opposition is just catastrophic opposition to this. I already know that I don't need to succeed. I already know that I've succeeded. I already know that I have succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. So the I doesn't have to do anything, and as such it ceases to be what we would say an I. Doesn't no longer any attraction to the I, the personality. I know I've already succeeded in realizing that I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Now, this is the teaching. Now, like mountain climbers, let's say we're enthusiasts. Really, to get to this, I already know that I've succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I already know I've succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. To get to this, it's like reaching the top of the mountain. And you have to be an enthusiast. You have to be a spiritual enthusiast, an enthusiast of truth. You have to be a hobbyist, an enthusiast. This is your passion. This is what you love doing. Now, a really avid enthusiast, they're going to be very, very knowledgeable about their craft, their enthusiasm, what they're doing. Let's say you're a rock climber. We had some people climbing this El Capitan recently in Yosemite Valley, free climb it. It's never been done before. And they're like extreme enthusiasts about this. This is their passion. This is their life. This is what they're dedicated to. Well, they know their craft very well, the basics, you know, how what they have to know in order to do this, of course. So in order to get to this teaching, I already know that I've succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I already know I've succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. We have to, in order to reach the top of the mountain, you have to know the basics. It's very important. The basics are sitting still for large chunks of time, sitting quietly, sitting still. The basics are full stop in the wow. As we get higher and higher, closer and closer, it's wow, 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 wow. This is amazing. Patience, allow the shock to wear off. We know that's the part of the basics. We also know that when we feel we're getting stuck, we have this affirmation we fall back onto. It's like a rope for a climber. They fall, they've got a safety rope there. Of course, they have to know how to do that. You're free climbing something. You're going to have a rope in case you fall. So, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. This is just part of the basics that an enthusiast has to know this. Because you are going to get into spots where you feel like you fall. So, sitting quietly is the foundation of it. Sitting quietly, spending a block of time of concentration. So when you get shocked and stunned by the great progress you make, unexpected, and just wow, yeah, wow, the world have never told me this. You go, wow, now you see this. Oh my gosh, it's important, very important. This shock, you just let it, you get used to it. You just let the continuity fear evaporate. Let the continuity fear gradually evaporate. You try to keep good habits in your life, for sure. Simple habits. Stay away from certain things that really distract you badly. All this stuff, an enthusiast on the spiritual path has to know this, of course. You cannot be just a dilettante and succeed in realizing you don't need to succeed. So for me, I'm a lifelong dedicated enthusiast of truth. And so I've had to learn, you know, what works. I have to have the basics covered. It's like that in any specialty, any hobby that people really know what they're doing. They really do. So many people have these passions, these enthusiasms of something, and they're really good at what they do. They know. So we have to be the same way here. It's not just something that you just casually discuss. Oh, yeah. No, it doesn't work like that. You have to climb that mountain. The mountain that is taboo, you're not supposed to get to the top. You go crazy, you know, you'll fail, you know, all this, the world tells you everything but what you need to know, actually, this world. Nothing but lies, nothing but misdirection, this world. Coming into this world is coming into misdirection. Fanatical misdirection. Horrible. Horrible place to come to, this world. I don't know why anybody in their right mind would ever come here. You're coming into the valley of sin, the valley of hell, of the hell of misdirection. The fanatical belief that we need to succeed. That's what you're coming into. So, I don't recommend anyone coming here, that is for sure. But now that we're here, and now that we've gotten thrown off track, our enthusiasm has to be to get back on track. And in order to get back on track, you have to be very disciplined. You have to know the basics in your meditation so you'll make progress. And that is sitting still, sitting quietly, sitting in one place, not getting up, not having a smartphone ring, not being distracted, not talking. Try as much as possible. Now, occasionally be interrupted, but you go right back and don't even think about it. But you try to say, no matter what happens, I'm not even going to get up. I'm just going to keep sitting here. So even if the answer is revealed to me, I'll just keep sitting here. No matter what progress I make, I'm going to just keep sitting here very anonymously, modestly, unassuming, humble, meek, recognizing I have a severe continuity problem. That's very important, recognizing that when you make progress, you get backlash, you get shocked, you get stunned by it, and then you start second-guessing yourself. Where's the answer? Where's my success? Where's my success? But remember, we're going to realize, I know that I've already succeeded. I know that I have already succeeded in realizing I don't need any success. Now, from the standpoint of the world, this is totally counterintuitive from the standpoint of the world. Okay. The world is what is the world trying to do? Trying to succeed in generating evidence of incapacity, the incapacity of spirit. Prove to God that we can change spirit, you see. So the world is fanatically obsessed with trying to succeed at this. And saying if we don't succeed in proving our incapacity, we'll be incapacitated. Which is a double negative, which is crazy. Of course, when you say to God, I've not been able to come up with even the tiniest shred of proof that I have any incapacity whatsoever. And God will say, great, that's true. You have no incapacity. Wonderful. Therefore, you don't need any success to be already. You already have no incapacity. So, what do you need to succeed at? We already don't have any incapacity. The only reason we would be searching for success is trying to be succeed at finding evidence that we do. And of course, this is the fearful ones here are saying, insisting that if they don't get this evidence, that they'll be destroyed, or they'll be completely incompetent. How can you be incompetent in not being able to find what can never exist? How is that incompetence? How's that incapacity? That's not incapacity. That's just manufacturing a fake incapacity. That's just willful pride on the part of spirit. There's no reason or logic or reason at all to that. It's a whim. It's nonsense. You don't say, gee, I was unable to find any shred of incapacity in what I am, so therefore that makes me incapacitated. This is inventing some sort of nonsensical dynamic that doesn't exist. You fail to prove that you're incapacitated, so therefore that makes you incapacitated. You know, we've made this law up and it doesn't exist at all. It's utter nonsense. So, I know I've already succeeded in realizing that I don't need any success. Therefore, of course, everything can appear to me is perfect because I don't need to succeed at anything. If everything's perfect, you feel like, oh, I don't need to do anything. It's all fine. Everything's great. Everything's fine. So there's no call to success, right? Whereas if you see all these problems in the world, all these troubles, you say, oh my gosh, I gotta succeed at this, I gotta succeed at that, I gotta, you know, all of this stuff is supporting. It just supports. The troubles of the world only support our desired belief in success. We need to succeed in finding evidence of incapacity. Of course, if we're succeeding at something, that means whatever it was it had in some incapacitance in it, because we're bringing it out of that. We're succeeding in bringing it out of that. But the real success, I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I don't need any success whatsoever. I don't need to succeed. Then everything can be perfect, but because you're not calling for it to not be, so that you can succeed in making it better, right? If something's already perfect, how can you succeed in making it any better? So I already know that I've succeeded. I already know I've succeeded at realizing I don't need any success. This is the teaching. This is the presence of the teaching. Now, Super Bowl Sunday, and of course everybody, many people are obsessed with who's going to succeed, who's going to win, who's going to succeed, this game of success. And it's all about that. But here we are, so I already know. I have already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing that I don't need to succeed. This is the teaching. And when this is continuous, this awareness is continuous, then you have a teaching, a presence of a teaching, the presence of truth. And the trouble is, this is so counterintuitive to the world that to maintain this is important. So when we already, I'm building up this wow, like, wow, this is really heavy. This is really important. So when you realize there's something very important going on, then this is a wow. Imagine if you were out in public and then some dignitaries and heads of state were there, and there was all this meeting, and you realize, wow, this is something very important, historic is taking place here, and they're making some great important decision, you know, between peace and war in the world or something. You're like, wow, this is very consequential. What's going on? You may just sit down and just quiet, just say, kind of shocked by how consequential it is. So what we're talking about here is so consequential that you can't even measure how consequential it is. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. This is all consequential in terms, you know, it's just immeasurable. So of course there's a wow with this. Goes beyond measure and concepts thinking. It goes right past it. And so you just have to be, you know, momentarily stunned by this and sit quietly. This is the discipline. Again, the real teaching is the last thing the world is looking for. The world is looking for success gurus, okay? That is not the teaching at all. It's the opposite. So the world is looking for in all the wrong places. I know I have already succeeded in realizing and knowing that I don't need to succeed. This is the last place the world would look for. Okay. So there's not many that are looking for this type of teaching, right? They're looking for success teaching. How can I be successful? But we know, we already know. I have already succeeded in knowing that I don't need to succeed. I know I have already succeeded in realizing that I don't need to succeed. Remember when Jesus came into the world, nobody really recognized him. He had to go out and select these apostles, and they said, "You know who I am?" And no, they didn't really know. And one of them knew, I guess, Peter, I guess, that said, but they're looking for success gurus. The whole world is. So I know that I've already succeeded. I know I've already succeeded in realizing and knowing I don't need to succeed. I have no need to succeed whatsoever. Consequential beyond measure. Full stop in the wow here. We call this wowism. Because this literally is a description of what happens as we get closer and closer to this realization. It's just, you know, wow. This is extraordinarily amazing. Just to get to this is amazing. Yeah, I'm stunned at that. A little bit, yeah. Let's be practical here. When you reach the top of the mountain after such an incredible effort, you say, well, okay, I was close to it, so it's not surprising I got here. But in the overall scope of the whole climb, you know, to get to the top, you just have to say, you know, you feel like, wow. But, you know, let it just burn off. Let it settle in. Be patient with it. Don't be arrogant. Be patient. Be meek about it. and understand there's a continuity backlash. So I know that I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Let me think, well, how can you function here? Because then you no longer need any situations that call for your success here. So that means the Holy Spirit should just take care of everything for you. And this is what Jesus tells us, and I believe I can see that that should be what happens. You lead a blessed life, a blessed existence, where you're not called to succeed, succeed. You don't feel like you need to succeed at all. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. And don't worry about how this gets applied. I just have to trust in it. So a full stop in the wow also has some element of gratitude in it. Just be grateful that you've been able to get to this. Don't worry about how it gets applied in the future at this point. Forget it. Just first things first, be grateful. Like, wow, this is just tremendous. This is wonderful. I know I've already succeeded at realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Now, of course, saying this to anyone in the world, they'll say, you're nuts. You're no teacher. That's crazy. You know, you're just an idle loafer, you know, what is it? So there's that aspect of it too. So it's easy to backtrack, you know, and say, oh no, I'm here to succeed, of course I am. You come in the world, you try to teach people this, they say, what are you talking about? You're here to succeed. We're here to help you succeed. What are you gonna do? You can't live if you can't try to succeed. Well, they don't trust in the Holy Spirit. Jesus tells the Holy Spirit will arrange everything for you, your whole life, all circumstances, down to the last detail. When you're willing to realize and say, I already know. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Because this is a statement of liberation from insanity. So the Holy Spirit knows we still have to have a presence here, body presence here. So, you don't know if it'll work until you actually try it, I guess. But what else is there to do at this point for me? So I might as well try it. So I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Just let the chips fall where they may. What else can I do? I feel this is it. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. So everything that calls out to me for success, I don't need anymore. That can be replaced with something that is not calling out for me. Help, 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 help. Here's an opportunity for you to succeed. Here's another opportunity for you to succeed. Wow, look at this opportunity to succeed. See, don't need those anymore. I already have realized, I already have succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I have already succeeded in realizing that I don't need to succeed. So I might as well give this a try, right? I mean, Super Bowl Sunday, February 1st. This is shifting for in the world. The world is shifting now towards even greater intensity. Even more situations that are screaming for help, screaming for success. Intensification of the personality, intensification of all of this time worshiping. So, it's a perfect time to express the presence of the teaching here, which is, I know I already have succeeded. I know I've already succeeded. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed at all. I don't need any success. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need any success. I don't need success. I know I've already succeeded in knowing I don't need success. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need success. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need success. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need success. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need success. I don't need success. I don't need success. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need success. Try preaching that gospel in the Silicon Valley. It's the very heart and soul of belief in success on this planet. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need success. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need success. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need success. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need success. So see, sitting quietly like this, you can't run out and try to succeed, can you? No. Gives you time to settle into it. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Full stop in the wow, full stop in the wow. Have you feel, you just drop, you know, you can hardly take it and go, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I do not need to succeed. To the world, this is the most blasphemous statement possible. To the religion of success, this is the most blasphemous statement possible, which is why it's so difficult to ground this, to have the presence of this teaching here in this world. This is why I was assaulted by this throat problem. Today is much better because of the work I did yesterday. And yesterday was better than the day before because of the work I did yesterday. And then the day before, the work I did the day before. So I've been working my way through this. It's taken, it's been about, 25 days. And it's getting better and better and better and better, working through it, because there's just this intense taboo against this. Basically saying, you cannot say this. You must not say this. You must not go there. You cannot say this. So, as I was getting closer and closer to saying this, my throat would suddenly be attacked with just tremendous irritation. And I'd trying to force me into convulsions of coughing. So I'd lose my voice and be unable to talk. Yeah. I know I've already succeeded. I know that I have already succeeded in the full realization that I do not need to succeed. I have no need to succeed whatsoever. Absolutely no need to succeed whatsoever. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I have no need to succeed whatsoever. Now, the feeling is almost like you gotta grab a hold of something. Wait, what's going to happen? This is blasphemy. This is unbelievable. This is what's going to happen. Turn everything upside down. The Holy Spirit has a very slick way of working, so I'm not concerned about that. It has ways, it knows that every detail of every situation all the way to the end of time worshiping, and it is able to do things in ways we do not understand. So, I don't know how it's going to, what it's going to do, how it's going to do, I don't know. But I do know that I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. This I do know. I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. This I do know. So let's just stick with what we do know. Let the Holy Spirit deal with this business, we'll deal with ours. I already know. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. The only appropriate use of symbols and concepts and terms, whatever, is to say I've succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. So it should be quite interesting now going forward. I don't have any expectations, so I don't know what to expect. That's okay. But what I do know is I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I do know that. It's hard to tell people, hey, everybody, I've succeeded. Oh, really? How'd you see? Well, I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. And they'll say, "His job is, Holy Spirit's job is, how in the world, you know, what can I do now? I don't know. I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed." Succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. See, when it seems to be too much for us, wow, it's like, and you hold on to the wow, full stop in the wow, and then at some point you sort of like sag and then you just go right, oh, I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. This is the enthusiast. See, the enthusiast is into this. We're not just like, saying, I gotta do this, you know, so terrible, I don't want to do this. No, it's like, for me, it's like, I can't wait, this is great. You know, this is what keeps me going. This is very important. So I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. And if I start dragging, I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit as God created, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. And we can add some emphasis. I already know that I'm not a body. I already know that I'm free. I already know that I am spirit exactly as God created me. I already know that I'm not a body. I already know that I'm free. I already know that I am spirit exactly as God created me. And I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded at realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded at realizing I don't need to succeed. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So I asked today, I asked Jesus, the Holy Spirit, I said, hey, I'm really in a bad situation, and from the standpoint of the world, I am in a terrible situation right now, actually, worse than ever. And I said, I just need to accept the right advice from the Holy Spirit. I don't know how to do this. It seems like I haven't been choosing right in life, you know, what to do, this and that. And then this is what has came up. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Now, who but the Holy Spirit could tell you this, to say this, you see? Right? Who has the confidence? Who knows to tell you this is the answer? This is actually the answer. This is actually the teaching that you can give, the presence of teaching. This is it. I know I've already realized that I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. So I'm in such desperate straits. I said, I'll try anything. I'll try this, absolutely. And it, I understand it, I get it. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. I know that I have already succeeded in realizing that I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in accepting that I don't need to succeed. I know that I've already succeeded in accepting that I don't need to succeed. So this is what we all bring into the world as far as spiritual awareness. We try to remember as we come into this world. We may have had experiences in the afterlife that clue us into this, okay? And then we come back in the world and say, I got to tell the people down here, you know, they don't need to succeed. You don't need this world. You come into this world all spiritualized, like, and then you try to deliver the message, and everybody just, huh? What are you, an idiot? What are you trying to joke me? You're a smart ass? What's the matter with you? You know, look, why, you need some help? Well, we'll help you out. Don't worry. We'll get you going. You just lack some confidence in the world. You need to be empowered, self-empowerment, you know. You need to be empowered somehow. So, and everybody gets discouraged. And they just finally spin it off into some new age success thing. It's got a bunch of spiritual rhetoric in it. It makes you feel good. Yeah, and meanwhile, it's just like, wow. I'm not quite delivering the message that I came here to deliver. It happens to everybody here. Certainly happened to me, and so it's getting back on message, which is so difficult here. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I know. I already know. I'm not a body. I already know. I am free. I already know. I am spirit, exactly as God created me, and I know that I've already succeeded in accepting that I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in accepting that I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in accepting that I don't need to succeed. Spirit doesn't need to succeed. If I am spirit, spirit doesn't need to succeed. So this is a great day. This is a historic day. Is getting back on message after a lifetime of not being on message. Struggling to get back on message, and having a difficult time of it here, for sure. I know I've already realized, I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. That is back on message. Maybe I said to the Holy Spirit, don't help me out, I don't deserve it. You know, I don't deserve help, I'm not on message, so now I'm on message, so I deserve it now. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. So ultimately I can let go of the entire world, the entire universe right now. Now what Jesus says is you let go of everything, and the Holy Spirit will return everything to you that is helpful for your mission here, for to stay on point with your teaching. Stay on track with your teaching. Whatever it is that's good for you, whatever is helpful, the Holy Spirit returns it and takes care of your life. It leaves out all the rest. This is what is said. So, I trust that, have faith in that, keep working towards that. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. What better day to deliver this message than Super Bowl Sunday in 2015? It's perfect. It's perfect. Perfect timing. Watch this instead of the Super Bowl. What time is this? I don't know what time the Super Bowl's on. I'm not going to watch it anyway. But I should say, watch this instead of the Super Bowl. Because, yeah, this is infinitely better than the Super Bowl. Because this is realizing you can get back on message. You can get back on message here. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. That's back on message. This is the message that we come into this world trying to deliver to all the deluded ones here who are suffering so terrible, dying so desperately to succeed in this world. Yeah, and you say, don't need, I know, I already know. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Just say that. Teach people, just say that. This is back on point, back on message. Got back on message. Back on track with the right message. It only took me most of my life to do it. That's not a testimony to my stupidity, it's a testimony to the fanaticism of this world. The fanatical misdirection of this world. It hit me so strong, I was like just wiped out by it. I stayed till about the age of 12 trying to deliver this message, but I got more and more discouraged, more and more discouraged. And I realized I'm going to be completely ostracized. People think I'm, you know, I have no place here at all. And eventually, you know, succumbed at that time. But I held on longer than most. I held on to the point where I was conscious that I was succumbing, you see, very conscious of it. And then again, I woke up in 1978 when I was about 22 years old. For a brief moment, I woke up and realized that everyone here is under this delusion. And I saw it, and then I slipped back into it, but I was very conscious that I can wake up from it. But it's been since 36 years of extreme effort to get back on message. 36 years. But what else is there to do here, really? You either do that or you slip even further off track. You say, well, I'll have to try it again. You know, get another body. Blame it on the body. Oh, you know, I just didn't have the right body. No, it's not the fault of the body at all. See, I just got trapped into believing that somehow I couldn't deliver the message because I didn't have an attractive enough body. If I had a really super attractive body, everybody would say, oh, yeah. Oh, we can accept what you say. Sure. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Oh, sure, of course, that's it. Now we know, because look how attractive you are. You're tall, you're 6'2", blonde hair, blue eyes, and perfect form, and it's nice teeth, and you're smiling at people and hugging people and saying, oh, sure, okay, now we understand. You know, this is our fantasy. This is our fantasy that somehow the body has something to do with it. If we just have the right body tell us this, then we will agree right away, sure. Because obviously you've succeeded in having a great body, and that's what we want. So whatever you say, and they'll say, yeah, sure, okay, how do you get this great body? Can you tell me? So, you know, I didn't bank on that. I said, forget it. I know death doesn't, it's not the answer at all. It's not about the body. It's about the fanatical resistance in this world, the fanatical misdirection of this world. And don't cave into their saying, well, if you had a better body, we'd accept it. No, that's not it. So I spend your whole life thinking, there's something wrong with my body, there's something wrong with my body, there's something wrong. There's nothing wrong with my body. Okay. The message of freedom resonates with our spirit. So it doesn't matter what the body looks like of whoever's delivering the message at all. I know I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. This is a spiritual message. So I always said, no, I'm not going to use death. I'm not going to go that route. No way. I'm going to get back on message here. I'm going to do it. I'm going to get back on message here. That's it. Always people say, well, if you just look better, if you just dressed a little nicer, then I'd believe you. And then I'd see you're a successful person. So they say, I want to see that you're a really successful person before I start listening to anything you say. Yeah. I say, well, I've already succeeded in realizing I don't need to succeed. Oh, well, what? Well, what is your success? I want to see you as successful. So you get obsessed with trying to, how can I improve my appearance? How can I, you know, how can I get people to listen to this? And you keep thinking, this is it? No, it's not. I've already realized. I know I've already succeeded. I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting that I don't need to succeed. I have absolutely no need to succeed whatsoever. I know I have already succeeded in realizing and accepting that I don't need to succeed in any way whatsoever. Now, the Holy Spirit supports a pragmatic need of success, of helping us get back to this message. So that's the Holy Spirit. So let the Holy Spirit support this, support whatever success happens. You see, I'm not going to, I can't, it's not up to me. Because pragmatically, the Holy Spirit was created to get us back on message, so that we realize we don't need to succeed. We have no need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. I know I have already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. So again, we give up, and we say, I just can't quite get back on message. But maybe next life, you know, I'll have a better body, better circumstances. People will listen to me then. It won't be so difficult. No, we come back, and they still say, you're crazy, you're cuckoo. What a nice person like you. You can be very successful in this world. What are you talking about? We gave you good genetics, didn't we? Be ashamed. You don't use your potential. I remember my teachers telling me, he's so smart. Telling me, writing on my report card and comments, he's so smart, so capable. It's just a shame that he doesn't think he's not applying himself the way that he could, you know. In other words, they said he has so much potential for success, yet he doesn't seem to be tapping into that potential for success. Of course not. I'm here to tell people that I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. So my teachers are like, what the hell's the matter with this guy, you know? And everybody's worried about me. You know, it's like, you know, something's not right with this guy. He's got all this intelligence. He's so intelligent, so intuitive, so and likable, and everybody just doesn't, he's just not trying. He's just not getting with it. He's not into success. What's the matter? What's the matter with this guy? So, I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting that I don't need to succeed. Nobody needs to succeed, actually. Spirit does not need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting that Spirit, which is what I am, doesn't need to succeed. It does not need to succeed. Of course, again, success can only be success in finding evidence of our incapacity. And there isn't any incapacity in us, so we cannot succeed at that. So what we cannot do, we certainly don't need to do. How could God create a need in us to do what cannot be done? God did not create such a need. There isn't such a need. We're just imagining it. I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. Stop in the wow here. A little full stop in the wow. There was a little attempt to disturb my voice, but it faded away. know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. I already know I'm not a body. I already know that I am free. I already know that I am spirit exactly as God created me. I can say, I already know I'm not a body. I already know I am free. I already realize and accept I have no incapacity. I have no incapacity. I already realize and accept there's no evidence of incapacity. I am not a body, I am free, I already know, and I already realize and accept there is no evidence of incapacity. So I don't need to succeed in finding such. I don't need to succeed in finding what doesn't exist. As a made-up need, there is no such need. God did not create such a need to find what doesn't exist. An incapacity to be free doesn't exist. So how can I find it? How can I succeed in finding it? I don't need to succeed in finding it. I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed in finding any evidence of incapacity. There is, that's a made-up need. We just invented this need. Now, as far as the Holy Spirit goes, I just have to say, Holy Spirit, you know your business. So I'm not going to tell you how to do your business. So I'm trying not to even worry or think about what the Holy Spirit is going to do. As far as asking the Holy Spirit for help specifically, I've never really found that that works for me. It's better to just keep on working, get back on track, and then we'll see what happens. But I just have to, what can you do? Let the Holy Spirit knows his business. I just have faith in that, and let the Holy Spirit take care of his business. I'll take care of mine. It's all I can do. All I can control is my business, and my business is to be on track. And that is to say, I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed, right? And finding what doesn't exist. I don't need to succeed in finding what doesn't exist. And we've imagined this need, that we need to find some evidence of incapacity, and meaning we're not free. But God says there is no evidence of incapacity. You're already free. You're perfectly free. There's no evidence. So you certainly don't need to find such evidence. You don't need to succeed in finding such evidence. You see how is this? So I already know I've succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed in finding what doesn't exist. And let the Holy Spirit take care of its business. I'll just full stop in the wow of this. Just stay on track. That's my business, is to stay on track. So, all this time, 38 years now, of intense work, since the autumn of 2018, actually it started more in the summer of 2018, of 78, the summer of 1978, so it's been, you know, since then. I woke up and then I realized, wow, I'm going back into delusion, but I can get back on track if I just work at it. And so it's been constant work since then. And again, not a referendum on my intelligence, it's a referendum on the ferocity of resistance in this world. Very few do get back on track. It's quite difficult. Certainly, we can get back on track. We have to. So it's something that's worth working on. And I always say, leave death out of the equation. I'm not going to rely on that whatsoever. As soon as you start relying on that, you're going to fail. You're going to fail. As soon as you start thinking, well, if I die, I'll get a better body, and circumstances will be better, then I'll succeed. As soon as you think that way, you start giving up the effort. And you basically admitted defeat. You say, I won't be able to do it this lifetime. I'll have to have a better outlook next lifetime. As long as you keep taking that tact, you keep failing and keep failing and keep failing. So for me, I remembered my past lives, and I realized, holy cow, not a single one of them worked. Because I always was told that this is my last life. Once I die this life, then I won't have to come back. I was lied to continuously. I said, it's nothing but lies. I thought my last life was the last one I was told it was, and it turned out not to be. So I cannot trust in death at all. There's nothing is just wait until you die and you'll be saved. There's nonsense. So from that point, I refused to ever use death as a crutch. I said, no way. It won't help me in the slightest bit. Because how can you deliver the message to this world, stay on track in this world when you're dead? That's ridiculous. I came here to deliver, to tell the world you can stay on track, get back on track. And of course, when you die, of course, you feel more spiritual. But then you're still pulled to help out of compassion, to help this world, till you come back in this world and you can't stay on track. That doesn't help the world. No, it doesn't help the world. If you want to help the world, you have to come here and stay on track. So, don't rely on death to solve that problem at all. And of course, since this is the place we're looking for evidence of incapacity, this is where it has to be cleared up. And we may be up in the afterlife, say, oh, this is great and everything, but then there's all these people, all these spirits, billions and billions and like trillions throughout the cosmos screaming, we're suffering, we're dying, it's horrible, we're so much, we need help, we need help, we need help. What do they need help? When you come here, they say, oh yeah, great, you're here. We can't quite find the evidence, it seems to slip through our fingers. Can you help us get a hold? Can you help us succeed? That's what they're looking for, some guru of success. And you tell them, wow, I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. And they're like, what? Who are you? What kind of idiot are you? Who do you think you are? They've already twisted the teachings, the previous teachings, in such a way as to support their idea of success. So they say, this teacher didn't say that, or this teacher didn't say that. You're contradicting these teachers. You're crazy, and they just attack, 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 nonstop. So, yeah, as long as there's all these spirits caught up in this severe delusion, you're going to want to help them. And if you haven't realized that you can stay on track even here in this world, then you're still in trouble. But if you make it here, you can make it anywhere, as they say. If you can stay sane in a lunatic asylum, then you got it. Then you can help. Then you can help. And as far as the twisting religions and the teaching, there's always going to be that. So let's sidestep the issue, because if we've a priori, we can already say, of course, that's part of the problem. But we don't need to tackle that problem directly. That's not necessary. We just need to get back on track with what is true. We don't need to say, well, who distorted it? How did it distort historically? What trace all those stories? What do you mean? We can get back on track right now. It's getting back on track that's important. But people obsess about the past and what happened and how. Just get back on track right now. I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. Of course, those who are fanatically obsessed and deluded will like, take any teaching, true teaching, and distort it. What else are they going to do? It's a given. So we just simply have to keep on staying on track here. And each one of us is our obligation to do everything we can to get back on track like this. Now, I certainly honor the creativity of all this distortion, as great efforts have been made, great creative efforts. But I know what everyone really wants is to get free of delusion. So we're going to honor that more. And the honoring that trumps the other. I certainly am not disrespecting the creativity. It's obviously, it's you know, it's wonderful. But we have to focus now on what we really want, which is to get back on track and to know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. Problem with honoring creativity too much is we're trying to use our creativity to find what doesn't exist, you see? And that's not the right use of creativity, actually. So you honor the creativity, but at some point, you do have to realize there's a line you have to draw and realize, and we do need to use our creativity in the right way now. So let's get back to that. We haven't lost our creativity in trying to find what doesn't exist. You know, we think we're so creative we can find what doesn't exist. That's how great our creativity is. Literally. Our creativity is so infinite that we believe wrongly, mistakenly believe that we could use our creativity to find what doesn't exist. Which is a lack of freedom, actually, an incapacity in our freedom. That doesn't exist. But we believe we could find it. We just needed to have a creative enough search for it. So people take offense when you say you can't find it. They say, you don't respect my creativity? Well, I do. But I do know that God's creativity created our creativity, and God did not create any incapacity whatsoever, therefore, of our freedom. Therefore, it doesn't exist, and therefore you can't find it. It doesn't matter how creative you are, you cannot find it. And if you don't accept this, then you're basically denying God. And have to draw a line there. See, that's a greater disrespect, because that's really disrespecting your own creativity. So by trying to use your creativity to find what doesn't exist, you are disrespecting your own creativity. So I'm basically saying, stop. You can stop, forgive yourself, and stop disrespecting your creativity. So I know that I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. So people say, well, I'm so creative, I can disrespect my creativity, and that's okay. I can find. Well, disrespecting your creativity means to keep trying to find what doesn't exist. And so you're never going to feel secure when you're trying to accomplish what you can't accomplish. And if you keep doubling down and saying, no, but my creativity can accomplish this, then you're disrespecting your creativity, actually. Because you're telling your creativity it can do what's impossible to do. Demanding of it what it can't do, which is really very disrespectful of your creativity. Basically saying that you're not good enough to, you know, you're not good enough creativity. You should be able to do better. You should be able to do better than God. You should be able to find what God says doesn't exist. And this is disrespecting God, which is disrespecting our creativity, disrespecting ourselves, denying ourselves, really. But we don't see that. We keep thinking, no, I know my creativity is going to be able to succeed, and I'm actually supporting my creativity by this, but it's actually not. Because we're saying our creativity is something other than what God created, that God created it, and that God is something other than God. That God is hiding something for us, or that God is unaware that there's this incapacity in our freedom. All this stuff is disrespecting creation. Not that that's a problem for creation, but it's certainly a problem for us. Feel a sense of guilt inside. We feel guilty that we cannot succeed in finding what doesn't exist. We feel there's a lack. Our creativity is lacking. We keep thinking, what's wrong with my creativity? Is something wrong with it? It's defective or something. No, it's not defective. We cannot find what doesn't exist through our creativity. Doesn't mean it's defective. So I know I've already succeeded in realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. I know I've already succeeded at realizing and accepting I don't need to succeed. Maybe I can get this up before the Super Bowl and say, watch this instead of the Super Bowl. So I can try that. Not that anybody will do it. Probably not. Maybe a few. We'll give it a try.